Welcome. In this video, I'm going to talk about streaming television, live television, from an HD home run to a web browser. And I made a previous video where I streamed from an IP camera to a web browser. So this is a picture of that, some video. And this will be very similar to that. You may want to go back and watch that video. I'm going to try and cover most of the same things, but you know, I may forget. What I have here is I'm on my computer, and I'm SSH'd into a Linux machine. And this video is mostly for more advanced users. I'm not going to include every single detail, but if you have questions, put them in the comments and I'll try and answer them if I can. What I have on this Linux server is I have nginx web server installed. And then in the var www.html folder, I have this index.html. And within that, I have this text here. And this is some HTML and JavaScript that I pulled from this site. And this allows your stream to work on Safari, Chrome, and Firefox. I showed it in the other video. I guess I could pull it up here. If you are doing just on Safari, you can use just this tiny little blurb here. And I'll put all this in the description or in comments or whatever so you can copy and paste it. But this here is everything you need on your HTML page to display the video. And the most important thing to change here would be this address. Two things: we have the web browser here, and then we need to run a script on the web server. And I have that in this live directory. Let me go here. And I have this stream.sh, so I will cat that so you can see it. And this is still set up for the IP camera, but I want to set this up for the HD home run. So what this does is this creates a playlist here, and it creates files, and then it serves those up to the web server. And these settings here, this HLS time says make the clips 10 seconds, and then this says make 10 clips, and then rewrite the old ones. And I'll show you this a little more when it gets started up. But we need to figure out which stream we're going to encode. So if you open up your HD HomeRun Extend, or HD HomeRun or HD HomeRun Extend. I'm using an Extend, and I'll put a link in the description to an Extend, and if you buy one with my Amazon affiliate link, it helps me out a little bit and doesn't cost you anything extra. So you'll go to a web page of the IP address of your HD HomeRun. I don't have the software. Let me see if I have it on here. I have it on my Linux machine. You can get this installed on Mac too, but if you type HD HomeRun _ config and then discover, this will show your HD HomeRun IP address, and I have two of them on my network. So I'm at 192.168.7. And you can go to the channel line up here, and you can hit this detect channels if you haven't run it already, and you'll see all the channels here. Okay, and we'll figure out which channel we want to stream. So I'll stream this 11.1, and you'll see when I hover over this, it shows in the bottom left hand corner it has an address. I'll just say copy link, and then I'll go into my server here and I'll open up my stream.sh file. So stream.sh. And then I'll replace this vid source with the URL from the HD home run. So now I will save this. I'll type Control O to save this and then Control X to exit out. So the stream.sh is all set up, and now I'll run it. If you're not familiar, like I said, this is an advanced video, but I would like people to learn. So if you're not familiar with scripts in the shell, to make them executable, you have to type chmod space plus x and then stream.sh, and that makes them executable. And I've already done that. But so now I can just type ./ stream.sh. And if I have another terminal window here in the live directory. So if I type ls, you'll just see stream here. Let's go back here. Did not like the encoder. Let me see if I can fix that. I'll just change that to AAC. We'll see if that works. Oops. Okay, so that works. I just had to change that that lib FAAC to AAC. And then we'll look in this directory here. You'll see it creates a playlist, this mystream.m3u8, and then it has mystream1.ts, mystream2. So it will create these mystream 1, 2, 3, up to 10. And then when it gets to 10, it will overwrite the 1 and make 11, and then overwrite 2 and make 12, and it'll just keep doing that. So now that we have this going, we can go to our web browser, and I'll refresh this. And we have live TV here. We'll have to hit start. And now it's playing. You won't hear the audio because the screen recorder I'm using doesn't do the audio. So we can also go into, let's see, Chrome here. Have it running there. And we'll go to Firefox. And now we have it running in three different browsers. So you could, watch this on your phone, your Android or iPhone, either one, it will stream. So another thing we can do here, so let's go back into the stream, and I'll hit Control-C to stop it, and we'll see all the files it created. So, and if you have an SSD, this could, you know, wear out your SSD eventually, I don't know, because it's always writing files. So let's remove these, and then we'll go back into our stream.sh. So I'm running the HD Home Run Extend, and this has transcoding capabilities. So if we go to the main page and then go to transcode configuration, you'll see this default transcode profile. So we can select one of these, or we can just choose one in our URL. Let's do Internet 240, and I'll show you how you can set that up. So if we go to our vid source here, and at the very end, we can type question mark and then transcode equals Internet 240, okay? And then we can go to our video here and we can remove all of this and we'll say vcodec copy. So when we transcode into Internet 240, this will transcode it into MP4 video, but the audio is not MP4. So we need to leave the audio here so it converts it to AAC, but we'll just say vcodec copy for the video. So this will keep it from having to retranscode or re-encode the video using FFmpeg. So it'll make it a little bit more efficient. Now we will save this and exit, and then I'll see if I have this. Okay, we'll run it now. And this will take a second for the playlist to be created. So it seems like it creates one of the streams and then it creates the playlist for the second one. So it takes probably about 10 seconds to get started. Okay, we go here and we refresh. Okay, now we have a smaller version of it, which would be very efficient. So you could pull this up on your iPhone or your tablet, and it won't take much bandwidth. And it's very efficient because the HD Home Run is doing the transcoding. So the one I like to use a lot, 240 is good if you're like watching on a phone and you want just the best optimization, but Internet 540 is pretty good. It has pretty decent quality and it compresses it quite a bit. I think I tested once, it compresses about 6 times smaller than standard, because the standard stream will be an MPEG-2 stream, and this is MPEG-4, so it's a lot smaller, and you are losing some quality, but if you're not super concerned about the quality of the video, the Internet 540 is a good option. So that's the basics of streaming from an HD Home Run to a web browser using FFmpeg, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. I know I may have left some things out, and I recorded that other video on doing the IP camera. I'll put a link in the description to that too. And it's very similar to this, but I may have said different things in each video, so you might want to watch it. But if you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I would appreciate it if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Until next time, goodbye.